see you coming. You know, Halloween is my most favorite time of the entire year. I mean, you have your costumes, your parties, your pumpkin carvings, but most important of all, trick-or-treating. Unfortunately, there are some dangers that come with trick-or-treating. But luckily for you, I do indeed have rules that can give you a fun, exciting, and safe trick-or-treating experience this Halloween. So come with me and have a first-hand experience as to what these rules are and what the consequences are if you don't follow them. It doesn't matter how old you are, where you are in the social chain, or how much pride you have. You should always wear a costume on Halloween. It's just common courtesy, especially if you're going trick-or-treating.
Michael, do I really have to do this?
You do if you want to get paid.
But you're not paying me.
Do it, Kurt!
Okay! Trick-or-treat.
Where's your trick-or-treater outfit, little boy? Sick him!
I got it.
Jesus Christ! I warned you.
I've done it again.
I warned you, but did you listen to me? Oh, no, you knew it all, didn't you? Oh, it's just a harmless little bunny, isn't it? Well, it's always the same. I always
tell them. Shut up! Do they listen to me?
Right!
Oh, no.
Unfortunate for Kurt, attacked by Bunny, never fun. Which leads us to rule number two, always hand out candy to trick-or-treaters. Candy for trick-or-treaters is just as vital as wearing a costume when trick-or-treating. It's like the circle of life, or rather the circle of Halloween. The givers hand out yummy treats, and the receivers wear silly costumes as entertainment for the givers. Oh, by the way, Kurt, nice costume.
Trick or treat!
I don't have any candy.
But mister, it's Halloween. Don't you know what that means?
Oh, but of course, my child, I forgot. It means that I have to be bandaged up for 2 more months. Thank you for reminding me. Stupid kids. Oh, my God.
Yeah, that's him.
Hey, I thought I told you to scram.
Ah!
real. It's real. There's nothing fake about this. I thought this was all fake.
Get in the car.
I don't want to go home.
Exactly apply to trick-or-treating, I find it to be a necessity to know. Keeping the jack-o'-lantern lit on Halloween is very important. Not only does it show your true Halloween spirit, but it keeps away all evil spirits.
Whoa, 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 whoa. What evil spirits?
Evil spirits? I could have sworn I said...
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you said evil spirits.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, I heard... Evil spirits. You know what? I'm done with this. I'm done.
Wait. No. We've only done two rules. We still have these other ones.
Michael, I've already been beat up by two things that not even my mamma would believe to be true. I am done. You know what? I'm going home.
No, you're doing this rule. You're breaking it.
Michael, there's nothing you could say in this whole entire world to convince me to go through with this.
No, a couple minutes ago, I was thinking how...
Michael.
How great it would be...
Michael.
If we went after this to go get some cookies.
Dang it, Michael, you know my love for cookies. Alright.
Alright?
Alright! Alright!
Let's do this!
Michael, I'm not doing this. You know what? Not even for the cookies. Just wrong. I'm not doing this. No! No!
I'm scared. You know what? Okay. This isn't that bad. Not that bad at all.
Slam it!
Well, that was quite unfortunate for Kurt. But luckily for him, the first appearance of the Slender Man is only an omen of him coming for you later. But wait. Anyways. The last and final rule of the night is always check your candy.
Help me.
Dang it. Now, the final rule for trick-or-treating is you should always check your candy before eating it. So, I got these chocolate bars from this really strange fat guy behind the 7-Eleven. I'm not really sure what's gonna happen when they're eaten. I don't know, but Kurt said he was gonna quit. He didn't want to do the next rule, so we're gonna have to trick him into eating these.
Oh, look, how thoughtful. Ooh, Snickers. Michael, that's horrible.
Well,
you're a horrible friend. Why would you do this?
Hey, this is a favor for you. This is a favor. You should have known to check your candy.
Michael, you don't do this to someone. You don't.
Well, this is where you've been.
I'm scared.
It's okay. I'll see you tomorrow, Kurt.
I know.
Well, that was quite unfortunate for Kurt. Unfortunately, we've come to an end of our night. Now, one may say, this is all a big scam. They get a couple laughs out of Kurt's pain. But I assure you, I take these rules very seriously. So remember, always wear a costume, always hand out candy, always check your candy, and never blow out the light of a jack-o'-lantern before Halloween is over. I knew it. Werewolves. Well, folks, this is the end of our night, and until we meet again, I wish you a happy and safe Halloween.
I'm a pumpkin. Hello. In the beginning, my life was idyllic. Days spent with my family in the patch. The sunlight warming my skin. Idyllic. Until they came without warning. Cruel hands dragging me roughly from my dreams into a wheeled box. I was carried past my brothers and sisters, my friends, my family. I cried out for rescue, but my kin remained silent and unmoving, perhaps fearing a similar fate. My home began to fade in the distance, and suddenly, everything went dark. When I came to my senses, I saw my abductors had placed me on hard gray earth. I was afraid I had just been left to die. Now I know if I had, I would have been lucky. The pain was incredible. I became dizzy, nauseated. They had cut a giant hole in my skull. They were now tearing my innards from my body and strewing them before me like ribbons from a gift. Moments later, the knives returned, impaling me over and over again. What made those people do what they did that day, I do not know. I began to think they were playing some sort of mad game, especially when they put a really big knife inside me and just sort of waved it around. When the cutting was done, I sat in shock, not daring to think that the torture might be at an end. But of course it was not. They lowered a stick of hot fire into my belly. Burning, burning flame. My captors had carved a gruesome visage into me, as if this was all some kind of demented joke. Who were these sick people and why had they done this to me? Why? Why? A while later, I returned to consciousness and heard someone approaching. A glimmer of hope sprang up inside me. Could these be my liberators, come to save me from this hell? No. It was a parade of tiny demons who stared at my ruined body. I knew then that the reason I had been hacked and disfigured was merely for the entertainment of these demons. They were even receiving some sort of payment from my captors for coming to see me. They tormented me and mocked me. My humiliation was complete. And now I sit mangled, deformed, waiting for the sweet peace of death to arrive. freedom, 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 freedom.
Me to do many tasks.
Well, this shouldn't be very hard for you.
This is a hefty price. Hefty prices come with dangerous jobs.
Nothing you can handle, I hope.
What is it then? Werewolf? Vampire? Banshee?
Witch.
Witches have been extinct for quite some time now. Probably just another Harry Potter wannabe.
I assure you, this is a witch. I've seen her do magic. No, she's always in her backyard doing alchemy and making these ridiculous rhymes. Oh, and the worst part is, she bewitched a bunch of brooms to take up water, to her house.
Witches have a tendency to do that.
Blood in my whole yard. You wouldn't believe how low my property is now.
So what you're asking me to do is eliminate your problem.
Yes.
Very well. It shall be done. Oh, that's my camera girl for my TV show, Monster Hunters. Not too good right now, but I assure you, it'll be the top of the box office in a season or so.
Good luck with that.
I'm a monster hunter! I hunt monsters! To another episode of Monster Hunters! Yeah! Those of you who do watch this show, you're in a real treat today. Because today, We're hunting a witch. And all of you fascists out there who claim I use cruel and unusual punishments, I can assure you I will be burning her on the stake. I love my job. So what, appears that she's not home right now. Probably going on a walk. Didn't expect her to be an active witch, but I'm flexible, I can go through this. I just have to play the waiting game.
Hey, I just met you, and this is what? This is crazy? What is happening?
It's okay, I'm just abducting you.
What are you doing?
Die. Dang it! That higher one!
I should really quit this job.
Rebecca Knight?
Yeah?
You've been accused of witchcraft. By the rules of the book that I myself have written, you shall be burned by the stake! Or tree. Don't actually own the stake. You're my first witch burning!
But, witchcraft?
Yep. So...
Wait! You...
What?
You can't burn me!
Yeah, I can.
But what if I'm not a witch?
Well... I guess I could give you the test.
Yes, the test! I want the test!
Are you sure? I mean, I've tied you the stake, I gathered all this wood.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Always with the stupid test. Fine, witch! You can have the test. Be prepared, though, or you will meet your doom. Stop recording.
But I'm so sick of rolling.
Stop recording! So, since the beginning of history, witches have, been given several tests. One of those was to be thrown into the water. If this witch sank, they were not a witch. They were okay. But if they floated, they were a witch.
So, you're going to throw me in a giant vat of water?
I thought about that, but I had a better idea.
What are you doing? What is this?
Recent studies show that witches melt to water.
What are you?
Melt, witch!
Are you insane?
That's okay, I'm a professional!
Oh, I'm so out of here!
So, it turns out that witches are not allergic to water. Which is good because it ends all raised questions about how they're able to stay hydrated. Anyways. So the first test was a flop, but... I assure you, the second one's gonna be way better. Oh, good. See, you're all dried off.
No thanks to you.
Right. On to next two. Ah, there they are.
Are those zombies?
Yeah, aren't they the cutest things? I found them roaming the streets. The poor things look lost, so I brought them into my home.
So, what are we doing here?
Well, it's quite simple. You see, if you're a witch, that means you can do voodoo. Voodoo zombies. So, well, I'm not sure if they're voodoo. They may be diseased, mutated, who knows, but I think it's worth the risk.
Whoa. Worth what risk?
Well,
what do you mean risk?
It's quite simple. I'm gonna throw you in there. Without a weapon.
No.
Without a weapon.
No.
The zombies are gonna they're most likely come after you. Most definitely eat you. Unless you use your voodoo powers, which you most likely have since you're a witch, to make them side with you and become your friends.
I'm not a witch.
In there!
No!
They're gone!
No! Drag on you! Hiya! And that! A lot easier than I thought it was.
You killed Fred and George!
You're the one who Throw me in there!
You monster! Oh, God. Switch the commercial!
But...
Just the commercial!
Wicked witches. Have you had an accident that wasn't your fault? Trip or fall at work? Suffered a personal injury or sickness? Then you could have been cursed by a witch. So get in touch with us at Witchfinders Direct.
We'll find some innocent woman, say she's a witch, and have her burnt to death.
Farmer Pocket of Crawley lost all his cabbages when they were eaten by slugs. He lost literally several shillings. So he called in Witchfinders. And we decided the slugs had been sent by the strange old woman who lived in the village. Yes, her.
Wasn't me.
Yes, it was. She's old and warty and looks a bit evil, don't you think? So we had her dragged away and given a fair trial.
Do you have a cat?
Yeah.
Then thou art a witch.
She was put to death and her cat sent to prison. So if you have anything go wrong in your life, call Witchfinders Direct. We'll find some innocent old woman and blame her for it. Witchfinders, because old ladies deserve it.
In the 1600s, confessing to being a witch could result in burning. Not confessing to being a witch could result in being tortured until you said you were a witch, then in burning. Not all witches were burned. Other punishments included forced fasting, exile, hanging, beheading, stoning, and gouging.
What are we doing up here?
What do you like to know, zombie murderer?
Oh, come on!
Well, as you can see, we're on a roof.
Really?
Yes, as you should have picked up on as we went up those stairs.
I meant, why are we here?
Oh, well, yes. Well, as you should know, witches have a tendency to ride on brooms. So...
Oh no.
You're gonna ride on this!
No.
Yes?
There's no way I'm jumping off of this roof on that broom.
Well, why not?
Why do you think I'll fall and die?
Or, you know you're a witch, and you're just gonna levitate.
If I could levitate, don't you think I would have levitated from here already just to get away from you?
No, because that's a bomb to us. And if I'm too far away, it's gonna go boom.
That's it, I'm out of here.
Wait, why?
Because you're insane, that's why.
Where are you going?
Home!
Don't you dare, Rebecca! Just walk away! Los es Benefica! Yes. I knew it!
How do you know of that language?
Let's just say, there's a reason why your kind are extinct. Or at least, almost.
Do you really think you can kill me with that dinky little crossbow?
Oh no! You see, this is no dinky little crossbow. I handcrafted this. It has the power to kill a yeti.
Well then, you'd be executing the wrong witch, wouldn't you?
And why is that?
Rebecca Knight, leader of the Dark Witch Defense League.
Impossible.
True. We have been fighting together for centuries in order to eliminate the world of all the Dark Witches and other joint forces, so you probably want to put that down.
Why have you not told me this before?
I had to make sure you were a legit hunter, not some little nerd who tries to prove himself by going to a troll's cave and then get eaten by the troll and then leave me with a 35-foot troll and a pickaxe.
Problems with this before?
Just a little bit.
Me too.
Anyway, I had to make sure you were legit because I need your help with getting rid of him.
Him? Who's him?
So I see you failed to do what I asked you to do.
Oh, fudge!
Hello again, Rebecca.
William.
Wait, you're the Dark Warlock?
Very good. Love seeing the creature's brains work so hard. Now step aside so I can finish your own.
Oh, snap. Come on, let's get out of here. Whoa! Oh!
loose. We're done.
I think I'm going to enslave this town. But first, I'm going to kill both of you. Then, your cameraman. Wait, speaking of which, who would watch this? I mean, have they ran out of ideas? Like, Storage Wars, that's a stupid show. And don't get me started on... That's cheating.
You are right.
Nice shot.
Yeah. That's funny. I almost forgot I had this thing.
Tragic.
Yeah. Good thing no one got hurt. Well, except for him.
So, what do we do now?
Well, what a job. Well, I mean, you get a license to kill whoever you want. It's pretty awesome.
You mean join you?
Yeah.
Could be interesting.
All right.
So, what do we do now?
Well, usually after I kill a monster, I go celebrate at Luunica.
Sweet, let's go.
All right.
So, what about your camera girl? Is she getting away?
Well, usually after one of these, she goes home and she edits hours and hours of film. Yeah, it's a horrible job. I'm so happy I have an easy job.
Yikes!
All right,
I said, oh, watch out.
doesn't matter how old you are, where you are in the social chain, or how much pride you have. You should always...
I just farted.
Oh my God! What just happened?
Let's go get